I'm Kevin Hogan with Rock Island Auction Company, and I'm here today with Richard Ellis, one of the world's foremost experts on firearms. We're here today to talk to you about our April 20th through the 22nd sale. You know, we just can't say it enough, the amount of fantastic, rare, and historical pieces. And speaking of historical, I don't think we have another more historical piece than this in the auction. When we can associate anything with the 16th President of the United States of America, Abraham Lincoln, you know, I don't think any president is more studied, more romanticized about, more remembered than Abraham Lincoln. Tell me about this piece.
Well, what we have here is a cased Maynard rifle that has all the accessories, and it's a three-barrel set. This particular set was made popular in a book by Merrill, Lindsay called 100 Great Guns, in which it was photographed as being from the George Rowbottom collection. And what we do in research is to try to find, you know, when these guns come in and we have estates, the gentleman that had this weapon has since passed. We find the gun. There was the book with it. All of the Lincoln paraphernalia, not the bust. We robbed those from our Americana sale to put with it. But everything that was here was all the Lincoln Association. And as I'm looking in the book, I see the target here, which was encapsulated in the plastic. You know, when I first see the gun, you know, being a cased Maynard, I said, well, this is a wonderful, one of the first pre-production sets, which, you know, spectacular in condition, much like the Colts that we talked about. In fact, this case, which we can, if we can get that out of there, is similar to the high-grade Colt cases like that serial number one that we looked at. It is anything of this league of high-end presentation, which you would never see on a Maynard rifle, is every bit the quality and league of a high-end, multi-hundred-thousand-dollar case percussion Colt. So you know, first of all, that this gun being in this rosewood case with a brass-bound case was made for somebody prominent. Okay. So we do not have hardcore documentation to this effect. Looking in this book, I see a target. Family had all of the paraphernalia. The gentleman is long since deceased. She said, I think this is Lincoln's gun. So we're looking at it. And in the corner of the target, we have the little initials, you know, with A.L., Abraham Lincoln. Now, might I caution you, we cannot guarantee this to be Lincoln's, but I would like to see somebody disprove this.
Right.
As for the intrinsic value of the weapon, you'll not find a finer cased Maynard rifle. It was a very popular weapon that was made at the beginning of the Civil War, which would date it to that time. And Dr. Maynard was most popular for him having made this tape priming device, which I don't know if we can get up, but this is the actual door that opens up, and I think there's some of the caps, you know, present within the case. He actually got $75,000, can you imagine, prior to the Civil War from the government for a patent on this device for the Model 1855 rifled musket. There's even, within this tin, there's some of the actual roll caps for this device. So it would lead me to believe, it's a well-known story with Abraham Lincoln having tested weapons on the White House lawn, one of the most famous of which was the Spencer repeating rifle, when Spencer went and he fired it on the lawn. And Maynard would not be a foreign character to Abraham Lincoln. You know, there was a contract secured for the Maynard tape priming device, which was on the 1855 pistol carbines. You know, we've sold those.
Right.
The 1855 rifles. Here you have this. You have the target. It's difficult to see in this photo. I cannot see, but it's a, you know, it's not a low resolution photo. Right.
But the target is there.
The target is there. It is initial with Abraham Lincoln. I'm not an expert on signatures, but then again, I would say disprove.
Right, right. And as you said, you know, presidential firearms presentations aren't, they are rare, but they did happen. You know, even Kennedy was even, you see him in the Oval Office with an M16. So it's not uncommon.
And the fact that it is a Maynard rifle, it's spectacular. Even if it wasn't Lincoln's, it's the finest Maynard rifle that we've ever had in this auction. Now, do you want to go there or not? Here it is. We have this offered for sale. You're the auctioneer right on the podium. I think that I'd be very comfortable with this.
And let's talk a little bit about the bust we have sitting on either side here.
This bust, it's part of the Americana on Sunday of the auction.
We're extremely excited for that portion of the auction. Something new that we're going to try here is this Americana genre.
And this particular bust was on the back was compliments of Monmouth Pottery Company, which not too far from here.
Right.
The interesting thing is Monmouth Pottery Company ceased to exist in 1905, so we know that this was made prior to that. Abraham Lincoln, the most beloved president in the United States, continue to memorialize him to this day.
Right.
Anything that's associated with him, busts, were made in and of the day. A very interesting item that I see is also a wood carving of a bust of him that was, I would date in the 1870s to 1890s. Yeah, very nice. You know, we do not know who the maker was. He initialed it. It's a very nice walnut object and very folky.
Right. And again, it's from our Americana collection, which also features furniture, paintings, and of course the wonderful Tiffany lamp.
Tiffany lamp and that ties in with our Tiffany guns we have in the auction.
Right. So just another sampling of some historical and fascinating pieces we have in our upcoming April 20th through the 22nd auction, and we're excited to see them all across the block.